Thank you, Rose, for the excellent presentation. Our final speaker is Dr. Suli Sui. She is a qualified lawyer, and she is now an associate professor in the Department of Social Science, Beijing Union Medical College. And she had a PhD in medical sociology from Amsterdam University. And she's a member of the Ethical Review Board at the Chinese Academy of Medical Sciences. And she's also has been a visitor scholar in some top universities, including the School of Public Health at Harvard University, Leiden University, and London School of Economics. Suli has specialized in the interdisciplinary field between medical science, law, and bioethics. And she's also a field researcher in the Center for Bionetworking. So today we are going to hear from her to talk about the cord blood banks in China.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you very much for this kind of introduction. For this afternoon's presentation, I will focus on the construction and development of cord blood bank in China. As a member of the Bionetworking group, so I'll link my research on the cord blood bank to the Bionetworking. For this presentation, I'll focus on the national cooperation of the cord blood bank in China. So there are so many relationships between the bank and the development of the bank. So we have the relationships between bank and the company, usually the biotech company, and also the bank and the hospital, research institution. So the bank needs to collect cord blood in the hospital, and also there's relationship between the bank and hospitals for the clinical use of the cord blood. And also the research institution needs the cord blood sample to do the research. And also there's relationship between the bank and the insurance company. Also the bank and the donator and the situation of the donation of the bank. And also the bank relationship between the bank and the clinic. This is the situation of the business model of the cord blood bank. And also there's some relationship between the bank and the bank, like the cord blood bank and the bone marrow bank. So now I'll simple to introduce the general situation of the cord blood bank in China. By 2010, China planned to have 10 banks in China. So if we want established a bank, it should approved by the MOH. So in 2002, Beijing and Shanghai Cord Blood Bank were checked and accepted by MOH and AAB and Asian Cord Blood Bank Organization, and also approved and accepted by the Provincial Health Department. This is the first two bank in China. And also by now they plan have 10 banks on the way to establish it. And by now there's seven banks, or seven cord blood bank in China. Were checked and accepted by now. Still three bank is under development, and the and not yet by not yet accepted by the MOH and the other organizations, they should have. So what's the bank work in China? So in this slide, I will generally to introduce the operation model of the whole blood bank in China. I remember the third speaker already told something about the private bank and the public bank. I think maybe that is a little different in Chinese context. In China, by now just have the 10 cord blood bank. Each bank has the public bank, maybe you can see the public storage and the private storage in one bank. So we say that they have the public storage and the private storage in one bank. So they combine these two in one cord blood bank. This model was called private risk public. They use the money charged for the private storage to support the free storage in public storage. So for the public bank, it is free for charge and it's open to the public. And the cord blood only used for the clinic treatment and also support for the research. And when the cord blood used, it is not necessary to inform the donator who donates the cord blood. Maybe it's not necessary to inform them that your cord blood saved in this bank was used. So that is for the public bank. And for the private bank, it's charged for the storage. The price is different. Different for the different bank. And for the cord blood, it only can used self used for the family, maybe for the relative of that family, because they charge the fee for the storage. This is in case they use it in the future. Every bank has two storage, but compare the storage of the private bank is much more than the public bank. So there's a date here in 2012 in the Tianjin cord blood bank. There are 15,000 unit cord blood in the private cord blood storage. But it's only 1,000 unit in public cord blood storage. This in Tianjin is 15 times different. In Beijing in 2012, in Beijing cord blood bank, there are 12,000 units for the private and 2,000 for public. It's also the 6 time different. So we can see the storage of the private bank. It's the unit of the storage is much more than the unit in the public bank. For each bank, they have the qualifications to operate or to build the bank. Also, they have some regulations to regulate it. So for the lay, they should enter the national plan, just as well mentioned. Their plan to establish a turn in China by now. So if you cannot get more, the hot is old sides that plan. Also, it should check it and accept by the MOH and the AABB and all the other organizations. And also should enter the supervision of the provincial health department. Now I will give the example of the Guangdong cord blood bank as an example to understand how the cord blood bank work in China. So they have two licenses. one is from the MOH, is from the nation. So this is a national lesson for the blood bank. And also they should, the bank should have the provincial license to operate the cord blood bank. And also you already have some cooperation with the company, and also the company should get the license. This is also the same from Guangdong, for the Guangdong bank. This is license for the new advanced technology company. This company named Tianhe Nuoya. Now I will take the Guangdong cord blood bank as example to explain the cooperation or main network of the bank, how it works. So this is the bank, hospital, and the company, they have the cooperation. So first, the hospital and the company and the bank, they have co-founder. So the mental and child health care hospital of Guangdong province is one of the founder of the bank, and also the Guangzhou Tianhe Nuoya Bio Company is also the founder of that bank. I just show how it is the license of that company and the license from the national level and from the province level of that bank. So they have the co-founder. And also they have the co-director of Cord Blood Bank of the Guangdong province. So director of the bank is also the CEO of that hospital. So we can see they have a very, very tight cooperation with the bank hospital and the company. Also the Guangdong Cord Blood Bank has the cooperation of the bone marrow bank. They have cooperation on index system with China Bone Marrow Bank. So if you fail to find the match blood, you can check in the China Bone Marrow Bank for the transplantation. Maybe the cord blood bank transplantation fail, you also can maybe find the suitable bone marrow in the bone marrow bank. Also the bank and the insurance company have the cooperation. For Guangdong Cord Blood Bank, if you save the cord blood bank in that prevent storage in that cord blood bank, you can get the insurance. So we can see they have some relationship and the cooperation in this bank, between this bank and the insurance company. This is the building of that Guangdong Cold Blood Bank, and also they have the collection net. The collection net for this bank, posts in the 18 cities in Guangdong. So in 186 in Guangdong province, they collect cold blood to this bank. And also they have cooperation in 151 hospitals. They have the very good cooperation with hospital. Usually the agency of the bank, they have occupied the hospital and through this to let more people, or usually the pregnant woman to know the cord blood bank, especially for the prevent cord blood bank, and they collect the, and they encourage them to store their cord blood in that bank. And also the cord blood in that bank supplied in all medical institutions in China. And also for the chat, this is chat for the private storage. Also takes the Guangdong Bank and Guangdong Code Guard Bank. Can see the fee and also the artist the time they have saved for the 18 years. And also before you save the before your artist saves your code blood bank in that in the storage, you get the test. If your artist pass the test, and your artist gets the contract of that storage. If you no pass, the family pay some and the bank pay some for the test. And also have some strategy for the how to attract more artists, more patients, more family to save the code blood bank in the prevent bank. They have to dig more the connection with the hospitals, and also that's agency to advertisements like a kind of advertise in the hospital to export the more network. Also, they have the price competition. So for different banks, they have different strategy to attract more clinic and to get more sum for the storage, prevent storage. I also have some issues here. That's the prevent bank and the public bank. I think there's many issues concerned this model of the this model of the operation of the bank. I think I want point also one. This is overmuch advertising on biological insurance against for the life-threatening conditions. They treat the bank as the bank of the life. Sometimes maybe that's not very true, and sometimes something is uncertain. We don't know. There are so many limited possibility here for use of the prevent code blood bank. And also the some risk and also the some limit they don't mention about the prevent code blood bank. About the limited disease and limited stem cell sum and limited age and weight for the suitable for the transplantation for the code blood bank. And also here, I think that's a limited time for the presentation, so I'll stop here. Yeah, thank you very much.